Beloved of God, it's Thursday, November the 3rd, the feast of St. Martin de Porres. This is Father Michael, along with the rest of the team, welcoming you to our time in prayer today at the God Minute. Last year on this feast, Father Brian gave us a beautiful understanding of who Martin de Porres was. And I remember him saying that he was born on December the 9th in 1579 in Lima, Peru, and that he received the Dominican habit when he was 24 and was assigned to the infirmary of the convent and remained there in service until his death when he was 60 years old. Isn't that incredible? What a beautiful sign of someone who loves the Lord and loves being in service of our brothers and sisters. Well, with that example in mind, let us begin as we do all things in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips.
And my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 9, Triumphant Thanks. O God, I worship you with extended hands as my whole heart explodes with praise.
I will jump for joy and shout in triumph as I sing your song and make music for the Most High God. For when you appear, I worship, while all of my enemies run and retreat.
I will tell everyone, everywhere, about your wonderful works and how your marvelous miracles exceed expectations.
O Lord, you will never, no, never neglect those who come to you in need. Listen, everyone. Sing out your praises to the God who lives and rules among us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 15, verses 3 through 6. So to them he addressed this parable. What man among you, having 100 sheep, and losing one of them, would not leave the 99 in the desert and go after the lost one until he finds it? And when he does find it, he sets it on his shoulders with great joy. And upon his arrival home, he calls together his friends and neighbors and says to them, "Rejoice with me, because I have found my lost sheep." The Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I shared a reflection earlier this year about my husband and asking for prayers for his conversion. Now, you wouldn't believe the amount of beautiful emails I received from listeners. There was a line in one of the emails that just simply took my breath away. The listener wrote, "And don't forget, God loves your husband even more than you do." So simple and so obvious, but at the same time, I guess I just hadn't ever thought of it that way. Of course, I want my husband to turn toward God, but if there's anyone that wants my husband to come back to God, it's God. I know in our God Minute community, there are many who have adult children who have left the faith, and probably every single one of us has someone they love who isn't a believer. Our gospel reading today reminds me that God loves these unbelieving people in our lives even more than we do. He wants their conversion even more than we do. In his time, of course. I'm reading this book about St. Padre Pio, and I'd like to share a story from his family life that I found interesting. So Padre Pio came from a beautifully devout Catholic family. He spoke so highly of the faith and piety of both of his parents and how their Christianity was the anchor for their family and how they raised their children. One of Padre Pio's sisters became a nun, and he obviously became a priest. So, very Catholic family. But here's the kicker. He also had another sister, Pellegrina, who went off the rails. She totally renounced the faith, lived rebelliously, and even had a child out of wedlock from having an affair with her other sister's husband. There was something comforting as a parent, I guess, about reading this story. I obviously don't have grown children yet, but I already stress about trying to do everything right enough to raise good, strong, lifelong Catholics. But when I read this, it spoke to my anxious mama heart. Padre Pio's parents did things so right that they raised arguably one of the greatest saints of our times. But they also had a Pellegrina. All we can do as parents is love our kiddos the best we can and introduce them to Jesus and his love and the faith the best we know how. At the end of the day, God has journeys mapped out for each of them and all of our unbelieving loved ones. And he's still with them no matter how far they wander. In fact, he will leave the 99 in the desert and go in search for that lost and wandering one until he finds it. And to end the story, Pellegrina was reconciled to God before she died. Thanks, I'm sure, to the prayers of her parents and her family. And of course, thanks to the almighty grace and mercy of God and his desire to search for his lost sheep.
Confident in the God who loves us, we have the privilege to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, we thank you for the example of St. Martin de Porres, and we give thanks too for the reminder of how great your love is for us. Continue to bless all of our brothers and sisters, those who are among us and those who are far away from you, that one day we may all come together in communion with you and our brothers and sisters. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, thanks so much for joining us in prayer today. Do take good care of yourself and one another, and we'll see you tomorrow for Concert Friday.